Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to go over various ways to concatenate values in two or more columns. So first we're going to show you the difference between concatenating and what a merged cell is, because they are not the same thing. And then we are going to show you how to use the concatenate formula. And then we're going to show you how to concatenate just using an ampersand and not a formula. Next, we are going to show you how to add additional separators in between the data and columns that you are concatenating. And then finally, we are going to show you how to put a suffix on the end of two different strings that you are trying to concatenate. Also, as a bonus, we're going to have some additional Excel training for you at the end of this video. So hopefully you'll stick around for that. Okay, so first let's go over what we mean by concatenation. If I go over here and I highlight these cells, and I go up to merge and center, and then I do the same for these cells, what I'm doing when I merge is I'm taking two cells and I'm merging that value into one cell. So if you look up here, you will see that this is cell E6. But if I hit Control Z to undo the merge, and I click here, I can see that this is E6. And this is F6. Same down here, this is E7 and this is F7. But when I merge and I merge this one, I can now click here and this entire cell is just E6 and this entire cell is just E7. So merging cells and concatenating is not the same thing. However, if I wanted to take the value in this column and the value in this column and concatenate them together, let's click in A6 and I'll show you what that looks like. So I can type equals concatenate with a left parenthesis, and then I'm prompted for my first text. Well, I'm going to click what is right here in C2, and then I'm going to type a comma, and then I'm going to click D2 and hit enter. And I can now see that I have put together what I have in C2 and what I have in D2. Now, if I click on this cell and I select this square at the bottom right-hand corner and just drag down one, I can see that I've also copied down what's in cell C3 and D3. So I've put those two values together right here. But I could do this without the concatenate formula. I could click right in here and type equals and click C2, type an ampersand, and click D2 and hit enter. And then I could click here again, drag the bottom right-hand corner, and you can see that I'm also getting what's in C3 and D3. So merging is not the same as concatenating. I can concatenate here with the concatenate formula, or I can also concatenate with an ampersand. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel, and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. So let's look at our second example. What if I wanted to put a space in between a first name and a last name? Well, if I click in C2 and do the concatenation formula again by typing equals concatenate with a left parenthesis, I can click in A2, type a comma, type a double quote, a space, and a double quote, and this will be the space that I'm using to separate my columns. Type another comma and click B2 and hit enter. I can now see that I'm getting the name with a space in the middle. But if I type equals here and concatenate with a left parenthesis, and I click A3, type a comma, click a double quote, a dash, and a double quote, type another comma, and then click B3 and hit enter, I can see that I'm now separating with a dash. And finally, for the last, I can do equals concatenate with a left parenthesis, click A4, type a comma, and this time let's do double quote, comma, double quote, type a comma, and then click B4. But before I hit enter, I just want you to notice I have a comma in here, and I have a comma in here between the quotes. So as long as you have something in between double quotes, Excel will use that as a separator for your concatenation. So if I close my parentheses and hit enter, you can now see I have a comma here. And for my last example, what if I wanted to do first name concatenated with last name and then also put an @myexcelonline.com at the end of it? How would I do that? I bet you can already guess, but I'm going to type equals concatenate with a left parenthesis, click A2, type a comma, click B2, type a comma, and then in double quotes, I'm going to type at myexcelonline.com. Close my quotes, close my parenthesis, and hit enter. And if I click this cell and I click and drag on the square on the bottom right-hand corner, I can see that I can copy that same formula for my other names and turn them into an email address as well. So as you can see, concatenate is a very useful formula for putting text together in Microsoft Excel. If you'd like to visit our blog and know more on this topic, I will include the link to that in the description below. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.